Yeah. Another vid you might be having to play back. Let's take that passion to HVAC. There were different means of distribution. Various heating cooling solutions to select from. We need the tools to do this. Let's cover them so there'll be no more confusion. Let's start with the all water systems. Complex, hard to maintain. All water systems. Yeah. Let's start the main thing. The first model FCT fan coil terminal. Hot and chilled water flows control temperature. It's piped to the fan coils where the action resumes. Air is blown across the coils, then back to the rooms. Since thermostats control the flow of hot and cold, this is used in buildings formed to have lots of zones. Since we want to go through each one. Next model, CLHP, closed loop heat pump. Should be carefully considered logically, it's got a high price.
It's got a lot in common with the last one.
Right. Circulates locally to let the cooling and heating penetrate. But it can make the heat from overheated zones circulate and feed into underheated zones. What a great system for hotels that are prone to make overheated areas like kitchens and laundry. There's one more raw water system to watch, see? The next model's HC, hydronic convectors. Say we have another one that works with H2O circulating. It has horizontal cylinders or fin tube convectors waiting to get hot water from the boiler room. Now maybe we should discuss the major disadvantage. It does not have cooling. Nope. And that truly limits the uses. Plus, it can't be relied on for ventilation.
Buildings need openings.
Right on.
And the hospital cost makes it sometimes be invoked.
The valves can have the exact level of heat controlled. Now all air systems. Where central fans circulate conditioned air. All air systems. Duct work runs bring the air here and there. In the first model, VAV, variable air volume, the air is conditioned at a central source. Then it's forced through the supply and return fans. It'll enter zones, various areas. Thermostats can't control. The most widely used heating and cooling system for large buildings is this one. The only problem is you can't cool and heat different zones with a system without secondary systems to a system. It offers advanced temperature control at moderate cost. Operating it is also economical. Watch, you can control the level of heating or cooling in a zone by altering the volume of conditioned air blown. The next model, CAV, constant air volume. It's like VAV, the air's conditioned at a central spot too. Like VAV, supply and return fans circulate the air through ducts through the inhabited space. The difference is the entire area serves one zone with no means of individual control. But it's good for department stores and the theaters, lobbies, auditoriums. The final type of system combines air and water. We require the least space of all on the last system. The hybrid one is AWI, air-water induction. Although it uses lots of energy and it's noisy, it's the most compact and provides a lot of control. See, it starts with the air and it's heated or cooled and then comes humidified or dehumidified and filtered. It then works in combination with the liquid after it comes out of the ducts. It's mixed with the room air that passes over the coil, which is also cooled or heated over the boiler. Your control of temperature is awesome. The thermostat regulates that and the flow of water.